I welcome all to this program, Voice of Saint. Today, May 19, our Holy Catholic Church celebrates the feast of Saint Peter Celestine. Saint Peter Celestine was the 11th of the 12 children of a poor Italian farmer. As a child, Peter had visions of our Blessed Lady, angels and saints. His heavenly visitors encouraged him in his prayers and chided him when he fell into any fault. His mother, though only a poor widow, sent him to school, feeling sure that he would one day be a saint. At the age of 20, he left his home in Apulia to live in a mountain solitude. Here he passed 3 years assaulted by the evil spirits and beset with the temptation of the flesh, but consoled by the visits of angels. After this, his seclusion was invaded by the disciples who refused to be sent away, and the rule of life which he gave them formed the foundation of the Celestines. A branch of order of Saint Benedict, angels assisted in the church which Peter built. Unseen bells rang, peals of surpassing sweetness and heavenly music filled the sanctuary when he offered the holy sacrifice. He had consented to be ordained, to find in the Holy Eucharist assistance against temptation. Suddenly, the poor anchorite found himself torn from his loud solitude, having been named by the acclamation to the papal throne, which had remained vacant for 27 months, resistance was of no avail. He took the name of Celestine to remind him of the heaven he was living and for which he sighed. He was 72 years old. After a reign of 5 months, Peter judged himself unfit for the office, and summoning the cardinals to his presence, he solemnly resigned his trust. During the remaining 3 years of his life, he worked many and great miracles. On the day after his abdication, his blessing after Mass healed a lame man. Saint Peter left the palace, desiring seclusion, but was brought back by the papal guards, for his successors feared a schism. Crowds had followed Saint Peter. Let he be prevailed upon to take back his office. He was put under surveillance at an agony. Content he remarked, "I deserve nothing but a cell, and a cell they have given me." And there he enjoyed his former loving intimacy with the saints and angels, and sang the divine praises almost continually. At the length, on Pentecost Sunday, he told his guards he would die within the week, and immediately fell ill. He received the last sacraments and the following Saturday, as he finished the concluding verse of Lord's, "Let every spirit bless the Lord," he closed his eyes to this world and opened them to the vision of God. Reflection: to the one who withdraws himself from acquaintance and friends, says the intimation of Christ, God will draw near with his holy angels. On behalf of Saint Fans Association, I wish a happy feast of Saint Peter Celestine. Amen.